High Court has quashed a petition filed by the Office of the Director of Public Prosecutions and the Directorate of Criminal Investigations for removal of Deputy Chief Justice Philomena Mulu from office over alleged gross misconduct. Take a look.
Deputy Chief Justice Philomena Mulu problem started when Director of Prosecution, the DPP, and three other petitioners lodged petitions before the Judicial Service Commission seeking Mulu's removal. This was after the High Court suspended Mulu's prosecution by the DPP over fraud-related charges in August 2018.
In my notes, my ladies will note that during the hearing of such removal, the threshold set therein is not as high as the one set during a court process. During that hearing, my lords, my ladies, the tribunal is not bound by the strict rules of evidence. And I submit, my lord, my ladies, that the reason why this is so is because the judge must remain above reproach, so that it does not require very hard evidence to remove the judge from office. That hearing, my lords, my ladies, would be conducted in private, pursuant to Section 9, unless the judge whose conduct is the subject of the investigation chooses to have the hearing in public.
According to Justices Said Chitambwe, Roslyn Aburili, and Weldon Korir, any petition emanating from the DCI or DPP seeking to remove Mulu violates the doctrine of separation of powers, as they have no right to do so. It's on record that Mulu moved to court claiming that two of the GSC commissioners supposed to hear out our case, that is Kiara Kariuki and Masharia Njeru, were biased. The claims that were later dismissed by the commissioners. Mulu is also facing corruption, failure to pay taxes, forgery and altering false documents. Before the Judicial Service Commission, the remaining three petitions have been suspended awaiting the outcome of the two appeals filed by Mulu and the DPP. Mariam Jahid, Switch TV.
Thank you, Mariam Jahid.